been, when I was driving there, I saw the massive project that you've been, backing on. The number, with the limited resources and all that. I don't know how you're able to do it, but I think it's God.
This project connects the three largest markets in Ghana, the consumer market, the single market, and the global market.
To be provided with light and air conditioning. To be provided with light and air
conditioning. So that makes it work. Thank the President of the Association for the American Constitution. To enhance revenue and in the process create more jobs, especially for you. I'll hand over to that people to the Honorable Commissioner with Wex to
share this with you. So, this demonstration under the leadership of our leader, Governor, is stated to construct a road in Amaki, which consists of about 8,000 shops. So, when these shops are completed, it is going to give our team use. Something to do, and the commercial activities will be fully done in this place.
While I was driving with His Excellency the Deputy Governor, I was looking at all the projects and I said, how will they be able to raise the corresponding revenue to deal with all the projects? And I looked at a lot of the small scale entrepreneurs all around and all that. And I said, if the government can at least help to convert this informal sector into a strategic market value chain where shops like this can be provided for them, that would be a great deal of, helping the state to generate revenue. And when the His Excellency said, come and see this project, and I just said, I was thinking about what he was doing without even knowing it. So this is important for us. When you help those small-scale, entrepreneurs who have great ideation to put together structures or infrastructure to enable them to put together their ideas into strategic market value chain, you just don't help them alone. You also help your state. So this is exactly what we need to be doing, helping these people that feel that they are not discovered to get discovered. And then putting together a place where they can come and bring the ideas together and create a market that will create employment for them and also generate revenue for the state.
And I said, how do you raise this revenue? How do you get the funds to actually do this? Especially in this period where revenue in terms of national resources really shrink as a result of COVID and other dwindling, commodities that the country really depends on. So I want to thank the governor for all the great job he's doing, and I want to thank him for the reception given to I and my team. But I tell us, media, we will come again here during the groundbreaking and unveil the main strategy and then ensure that the vision that has brought us together, which is Nigeria, must be upheld by all of us. It doesn't matter where you're from. I mean, I'm from the Niger Delta area of River State, but I'm here up north trying to demonstrate God's blessing for me as a Niger Deltan. Whatever God has given to you is not yours, but for humanity. And we must recognize that if your essence is humanity, humanity will detect the pace and design your schedule. And you have to be humble when you are giving something to those who can't give back to you. And that's the only gift that God accepts. And I believe we're all the same. Muslim, Christian, we're all one. We're all worshipers of Allah through different mediums that we believe that we can communicate to you. So we shouldn't allow our culture and religion and geopolitical zone and ethnicity to divide us. Instead, it should be that diversity that brings us together to get the best out of it. And that's why God has given us.
Me, what I've seen here today is exceptional. You know, the training center that has everything, all in comparison. Training center that considers today's opportunity and builds tomorrow's future. And I think the governor has done everything for us. He's provided for the young ones, provided for the old ones, and all of that. He thinks about the wellness of the common people. Infrastructure builds where you would think that nobody would think about. Considering, you know, the safety of the people. You see that bridge where he built a tunnel. You know, he built a bridge and then that was a challenge. And then he provided the tunnel to address the challenge. So it's a governor that, to be honest, I've not seen any governor like him, you know, all through the country. And I want to say that the kind of people should celebrate him. And all other Nigerians should also come and see what is going on here and celebrate them. The media should celebrate them. Because, you know, if you are from Kano State or you're from the North, just come down here and see all what the governor has done and take a bite. Steal some of the ideas he has put on the ground and then build your own community and your own state. That's what we need. We shouldn't run away from, you know, learning from those who have made it and then building ours from there so others can come and learn from. So I'm happy to be here and I'm leaving Kano State right now back to Abuja. I will continue to communicate the messages that I've also gotten here to other people who think that the only way to tear a man down is to call him names. Take the good part of a man and let go the part that you don't like. So thank you, Excellency. God bless you. And you have set the benchmark for all the young ones to build on. And I've seen, and I'm going to tell the message, which is the good news of competence and capacity. Demonstrated life. Thank you very much, sir.
Blessed.
Thank you, sir.
Because I have an exceptional visitor, Jack Rich, a man who lives in West Nigeria, a man who lives in Nigeria, a man who has no barrier in terms of religion, in terms of tribe, ethnicity. All the people of Nigeria are one. We are all working for the progress of this country. Somebody coming from River State, South geopolitical zone, coming to Kano and building a 300-bed hospital, more than hospital. This is a corporate social responsibility by one man who lives in one Nigeria. These are the types of people that we're looking for instead of seeking. Instead of, you know, campaigning for disintegration, this is a symbol of unity. This is the type of people who, when we all come together, it means that Nigeria will be taken to the next level.
Exactly.
We have to, you know, take advantage of our diversity, because our diversity is an opportunity, and our diversity is an asset. Every ethnic nationality in Nigeria has some inherent capacities that when handled together will make the country move forward. Isn't it the worst of our time of the decoration, worst of our time of division, worst of our time of this and that? I think it's the time that we should be born again.
Exactly.
So that we make Nigeria great. So the type of people of Jack Rich, Nigeria is certainly on the right path. So young man, you are most welcome. To other part of the country. We appreciate you. We thank you for what you are doing to the people of Kano State. In fact, you are not only building one Nigeria, you are also building generation, because you are a young man. You are showing young people how it should be. So we thank you for coming.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, sir.
Jackie!
the reason I am standing to speak to you, mothers, and the reason I'm standing to speak to you, fathers, and the reason I'm starting to speak to you, young ones, yesterday, which was my yesterday, you are better than me before. Yesterday, you are better than me. Because I lost my parents, I lost my mother when I was 10 years old, I was suffering. I used to be on the street. I used to sleep under the bridge.
Subhanallah.
I used to sleep in the bush. I used to sleep in an uncompleted primary school building. Sometimes no food to eat. I've gone through a lot. But today, I am giving to you. So you have to know that whatever you take from me, don't just consider it what you used to get from others before. Take it and take a little to your mother. Take a little to an elder. Take a little to your spiritual father. And say, I got little from Jack Rich.
Sorry, okay.
And Jack Rich means strong and wealthy. And this little I have gotten, I am giving you little, so please pray for me.